Oh!
Ah, we're good. This is a...
Okay, so it's usually Linus who shows up at somebody's house to do an extreme tech upgrade sponsored by Intel. But the problem is that he's usually here to upgrade a PC. As far as I'm aware, there's never actually been a PC in this house. So maybe we can get Mark to let us in a little bit on why it is he's never had a PC.
Hello there.
All right, well, I think the last time I was in a house without a PC, and it was in the 1990s, so why don't you show me what it looks like?
Sure. All right. Well, everything is integrated with HomeKit. I have the Eero device here, which is the mesh network, one that works with HomeKit.
You don't want to, like, mount it somewhere, like up here? Like with...
I'm working on it. This is the kitchen, so these are, like, my knives and everything.
Oh.
Before I was... an editor. I used to be a butcher. Yeah, so before I cut videos, I cut meat.
Well, I guess it's a natural evolution.
Yeah.
So who's the very good boy that's been following us around all the time?
Well, this is Ben. He's my dog. He's got 2,000 followers on Instagram.
Really?
Yeah. Ben the Terrier. Fun fact, he's not actually a terrier. Don't tell anyone.
Is that a plasma TV?
Yes, a 42-inch plasma TV. I did not buy this.
So it wasn't specifically for playing games?
Oh, definitely not.
I'm guessing the reason we're here, though, is you're going to replace it.
Absolutely.
What are you replacing it with?
A 55-inch LG OLED TV.
And there's also a soundbar over here. I noticed you don't have a soundbar or any kind of speakers right now.
So I got this, I chose this Sonos Arc, mainly because it's HomeKit integrated.
Oh.
So I can connect it very easily with AirPlay. I know a lot of people in the comments are gonna say I shouldn't mount it over a fireplace.
This is, we'll say that.
Yeah.
This is true. Talk about burn-in.
The air purifier over there is also HomeKit enabled.
Why do you need an air purifier to be HomeKit enabled?
So I can shut it off when we leave the house.
Do you not have a remote control?
The remote control is my iPhone. So continuing with the home tour.
Okay.
It's upstairs. So this is kind of my home office slash studio.
Okay.
Slash server room slash...
Server room?
Everything. Well, yeah, here's my server.
Huh. You got an actual rack?
Yeah.
Is it just the Drogo or Drobo?
Nope.
Is it the camera?
Nope. Come over here. It's that.
What? This?
That's my server. And this is my desktop editor, which is a VCR.
Yeah, that's about what I thought that was.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we got this when the first iMac came out. Came packaged with the computer. I don't get rid of my Macs, I just repurpose them for other uses.
So you don't get rid of your Macs. Where's your iMac G3?
I don't know. Oh. I was looking for it. I actually have a G3, a G4 Cube. I have a 6400 Power Mac. Also have an Apple II Plus.
Okay.
That I actually think my mom got rid of a while.
Got rid of?
I moved out and then we moved back in.
So this is your mom's place?
Not exactly. Look, she lives with me.
Okay. Whatever you say. I see you also have a 3D printer.
Yep. This is the one I got from work.
From the office.
Yeah.
Yeah, stolen from the office.
Yeah, that's the excuse we're using. Despite, you know, being an Apple guy, I do play games. It's not like I don't have Windows installed on here. It's through boot camp.
Boot camp?
Yeah, boot camp.
That's illegal.
I mean, it is kind of now with M1. And that's part of the reason why I really need a PC.
Right. Yeah. You can't upgrade.
Well, I can't upgrade Windows anyway because I have an eGPU. And
that's what that is.
Yeah. In order to game with it, I should be plugging into the DisplayPort or HDMI or whatever into the GPU. But this monitor here is Thunderbolt only. So I have to plug it into the MacBook. But let me show you how I have to boot into Windows. There's the real challenge. So to do this properly, I need to set the startup disk to boot camp. What I usually do is I press restart and then I unplug everything. I gotta hot plug it right now into the left port.
Okay, cool.
Huzzah, all right. So now the fun part. So now what I have to do is I have to unplug the eGPU, plug it into the other side, unplug it again.
Wait, what?
And then plug it in again. And now it's recognized. Now I can plug everything else back in.
So tell me something.
Yep.
Where are you going to set up your actual build?
Right here.
Do you have a display for it?
This is the display. So I got a EVGA 3080 because they're the only ones that had GPUs for some reason.
Fair enough.
I got these Lian Li fans because I was recommended them and they just came out and they look pretty. That's what I'm going for. Clean and a red theme. That's the other thing.
A red theme?
Yeah.
You know, you do know that this is sponsored
yes,
by Intel.
Yes, I understand that. And you know, I've, as an Apple user, I've always been Team Blue.
Yeah.
And before I was Team Blue, I was Team Big Blue. So we got a Core i7.
Yep. 11700K.
Yep. And then this is the most important piece, the puzzle.
Mm-hmm.
Because this is the Z590 Ace from MSI. And the reason I got it is because it has Thunderbolt 4. And that's what I need to make it work with that monitor.
Mm-hmm.
The big ticket item here is the case.
Please don't tell me that's an Antec 900.
Nope. This is a Toe 2.0.
What?
You got that case?
Yeah. So the reason I got this case is it was featured in the first video I was on, in an LTT video. If I'm gonna get a PC, I'm gonna go all out PC.
This case is weird.
It's literally made of Windows.
So the Core i7-11700K is a 8-core, 16-thread processor with a base frequency of 3.6 gigahertz with a maximum turbo of 5.0. And thanks to this rather beefy cooler, we should be able to actually do that much more often than we normally would be able to. Now, Mark's not here to defend himself, but I don't see any RAM here. For now, I'm gonna move on to the NVMe SSD. Now, this is the Saverint Rocket NVMe 4.0. These are actually quite good drives. Price to performance wise, it's kind of tough to say no to them.
Yeah, I'll get you the RAM.
Oh, the RAM question. It's finally being answered. Where is it?
Here's the answer.
What is it? Crucial Ballistics. Okay, so DDR4, 3200, 15, 18, 18, 36. So, it's fine.
It's fine.
Did you? Yeah, this is, you took this from the office.
Oh, I was kicked out of the computer club.
What?
Yeah, in high school, I was kicked out of the computer club.
Why?
Because I was a Mac user. nothing important. I just kind of screwed one of the drywall anchors into the wall somehow. I don't even know how that works.
So you're probably asking like, okay, this looks amazing. I'm holding basically a Tetris block. How do we power it? Well, we've got this. It goes straight on something like, not like that. Hang on, what? So it goes on like that. I don't look like a fool at all. So you just snap it on there and you're good to go. Well, I noticed that you don't have a whole lot of RGB. These fans are basically it.
I want to make it tasteful.
You don't think unicorn vomit is tasteful?
Unicorn vomit? No. A case made of glass? Yeah.
Long story short, I've got the fans in and I've got the fan controller and RGB hub in. I mean, I still need to do cable management, but there's not a whole lot of cable management opportunities in this case, unfortunately. So we'll have to see how that goes.
Well, to go with the red and black build, we got
purple?
Purple and blue.
Brown?
Brown. Brown and purple.
Okay, so I've discovered a slight problem.
Yeah.
Okay, so there are two of these.
Yeah.
There's only one of those on the board.
Yeah.
Which would you prefer, the Type C or the Type A's?
Maybe Type C.
That's what it currently looks like.
Dang.
Yeah. Everything should be good to go from here. All that's left to do is to throw the side panels on and power it up.
Hey, let's see if this works. Is it this?
No. There you go.
Holy crap.
Hey!
That's a lot of light.
Sure is. That is some grade A rainbow barf.
Ben seems to like it.
Yeah, it looks like it's like 54, 60 FPS.
Wow.
Dipping into the 40s, but like maybe you've got it 5K. Turned up to unreasonable in 5K. So. Yeah. So I guess this is the part where we're taking down the old TV and putting the new one in.
Pretty much.
All right, you got a drill?
If not, we're just gonna use our knives.
Yeah, we'll use your knives. That'll work.
Yeah, man. You can.
Oh!
Oh, we're good.
Oh! All I did was let up off it a little bit.
Yeah. I'm kind of glad it's you and not Linus right now.
I can't see. I think you need to go up a bit. Oh, here we go. How do we lock it in place?
It is, and I think, I don't know what this is for. Oh, wait, hold on.
To unlock the TV from the wall plate, pull down and hold both
of
those.
Yeah, good thing I didn't pull down on those.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we get it right the first time.
Yeah. Wow, that's like the first time in any Linus Tech Tips video.
Well, that's because we didn't just like, oh, what does this do, yank?
Yeah.
We're like, what does this do? Oh! Yeah, don't do that.
Yeah, we read the manual. Always read the manual. You see, I kind of peeled a little bit already.
Why would you do that? Oh, it's actually making a beautiful sound.
It's like a campfire.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that looks pretty.
So another reason I chose the Arc was mainly because sometimes I don't want to have the TV on, especially it's an OLED, and I do want to play, but I do want to play music or something. And I can just, you know, from the laptop down here or upstairs, just AirPlay straight to this on the network.
So what you're saying is it's a glorified HomePod.
Yeah. No, the HomePod kind of sucks. This is just it. I'm not like a fanboy of every product Apple comes out with. I don't have an Apple Watch, and literally everybody at the office has an Apple Watch. Yeah. So there's your explanation there.
Press the OK button, wheel, on your remote.
OK, I'm getting it. God. Whoa.
Whoa.
Did you destroy anything?
What?
Oh.
Oh, that's the legs, right?
Holy crap, that's a huge remote.
Wow, that remote is big.
Yeah, press the wheel. Yeah, it looks pretty good to me.
That is.
Sounds good to me.
Dang.
All right, that's gonna just about do it, I think. We've got the TV mounted, we've got the PC built, everything is good to go. So hopefully Mark enjoys his newly upgraded spaces. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and part of Intel's Extreme Tech Upgrade series. Mine was the first one, but there's plenty more that you can watch. There's David's, there's Andy's, there's Colton's, there's Riley's, there's Dennis's. If we can twist enough arms at Intel, we can get everybody one of these. So stay tuned for more of these. And thanks again for Intel sponsoring this series. What is he?
He's a chihuahua poodle and a few other things.